coming?
No, because they're separate persons.
Can you show me here?
Jesus is the second person of the Trinity. God is the first person of the Trinity. Okay.
Okay. Well, let's see here.
Jesus is the second person of the Trinity. God is the first person of the Trinity. Okay.
Okay. Well, let's see here.
Jesus is the second person of the Trinity. God is the first person in the Trinity. Okay.
Okay. Well, let's say Jesus.
Like this. Yeah.
Oh God.
Is this revealing a deeper subconscious rejection of the Trinity doctrine? A Freudian slip, if you like. She calls the first person God, thus subconsciously she might be differentiating between God and Jesus, whilst at the same time suggesting her subconscious mind may well be processing a hierarchical understanding of the Trinity where the first person, the Father, is seen as having primacy over the subordinate second and third persons, hence why the Father is called God more readily, even when such a statement differentiates between God and the other persons of the Trinity doctrine, the Son and the Holy Spirit. For another example of possible cognitive dissonance and or a Freudian slip, listen to this American evangelical polemicist.
I want to talk about Jesus, because Jesus is absolutely relevant for today. God bless Jesus. You know, in 30 years that I've been working with Muslims, and I want to talk about Jesus, because Jesus is absolutely relevant for today. God bless Jesus. God bless Jesus. God bless Jesus.
He says God bless Jesus despite officially believing Jesus is God. He's differentiating between God and man. The man in this case is Jesus. Is there an issue here of cognitive dissonance where his mind subconsciously rejects the idea of a man, Jesus, being God and ultimately just views Jesus as distinct being from God?
So when I came to the very interesting Moody Bible Institute doctrinal statement, I was surprised and somewhat shocked to find them saying, God is a person who has revealed himself as the Trinity in unity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Three persons and yet one God. I'll read that again. God is a person, three persons, and yet one God. This does not propose anything to our minds that makes any sense at all. It's entirely incoherent. One person cannot be three persons. But you know, the Athanasian Creed that was recited week by week in church for centuries simply says that the Father is almighty, the Son is almighty, the Holy Spirit is almighty, but this is not three almighties, which leaves the human brain in a fog. It's no better than saying, this is a chair, that's also a chair, and that's another chair, but it's really one chair. We are not talking coherent language. And I'm reminded of the famous statement of a Dr. Hay, who lectured at Cambridge on the Trinity, and he said, we must be always industrious to say that our Trinity is completely incoherent and completely unintelligible. It makes no sense at a basic language level, and therefore it leaves the brain in a fog and communicates nothing.